Good morning. Welcome to the Children's Ministry at the Fort Bend Church. I am Andrea Jackson. It's prayer time. Let us pray. Dear God, please hear our prayer. We praise your holy name. We thank you for your love. We thank you, God, for Jesus. We thank you that he died on the cross for our sins. Dear God, we thank you for this day. We thank you for the Bible in our church. We thank you for our pastor and our parents. We thank you for our teachers and our friends. We love you, God, our Father. God, please help us to obey you and to make you smile. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Let's stand and sing, "This Is the Day." In our Bible story today, we will hear about Israel's first king. A king is supposed to take care and lead the people. We will also hear about a man looking for his father's lost donkeys. Saul was Israel's first king, and God was going to use him to fight some important battles. Kings and queens wear crowns to show that he or she is in charge. Soldiers protect their country or a nation. Last week, we learned that God chose Saul to be Israel's first king. In today's Bible story, we are going to learn that Saul was Israel's first king, and God helped Saul to lead the Israelite soldiers in a battle with their enemies. I want you to always remember the Bible is God's word. It tells us about who God is and what he is like. We can trust God's word and know that God has given it to us so that we can know him. Today we are reading from the book of 1 Samuel. Samuel was a judge and a prophet. Let's watch the Bible story, God Made Saul King, from 1 Samuel chapter 11.
Hello everyone, I'm Megan.
And I'm Jesse.
Hey Megan, guess what?
What?
I played with my soccer team yesterday and we have a new coach.
Oh wow, that is exciting.
Her name is Coach Lindsay and she is Connor's mom.
Oh, coaching a team is a big responsibility. I'm glad she's helping. You know, that actually reminds me of our Bible story today.
Is it about a soccer team?
No, but a long time ago, the people of Israel were led by a judge named Samuel. When they demanded a king, God chose a king for them. His name was Saul. Being king of a nation is a big responsibility. Here's today's Bible story.
One day, Saul was walking home after working in a field. He heard a strange sound. The people in his town were crying loudly.
"Why is everyone crying?" Saul asked.
The people said, "Some messengers just came from another city with a message. They said that Nahash, the leader of the Ammonites, had come to capture the people." The people in the city tried to talk to Nahash. "Let us serve you," they said, but Nahash wanted to hurt them. He said if no one came to help them, they would have to do whatever Nahash wanted. When Saul heard this news, God's spirit came on him and he was very angry. Saul sent a message throughout the land calling for men to come and fight. The people came together to fight against Nahash and his army. So Saul sent messengers back to the city. The messengers told the people, "Help is coming tomorrow." The people were so happy. Then they sent a message to Nahash. "We will meet you tomorrow, and you can do whatever you want to us." The next morning, Saul brought his army to the city. They went into the camp where Nahash's army was staying, and all of Nahash's soldiers ran away. Saul said to the people, "Today the Lord has rescued Israel." Then all the people made Saul their king. They thanked God and celebrated. God chose Saul to be the king in Israel. With God's help, Saul brought the Israelites together to win the battle. God sent his son Jesus to be our king forever. Jesus came to rescue people from sin and death.
Our Christ connection tells us that God chose Saul to be king in Israel. With God's help, Saul brought the Israelites together to win the battle. God sent his son, Jesus, to be our king forever. Jesus came to rescue people from sin and death. Now it's time to review. Do you remember what the Israelites asked Samuel to give them? Here's a hint. They wanted to be just like all the nations around them. That's right. They wanted an earthly king to lead them, even though God was their true king. Do you remember what Samuel poured on a man named Saul to show that God had chosen Saul to be king? Yes, it was the oil. Today's Bible story happened after Saul was anointed. A man named Nahash was making trouble for the Israelites, and they needed someone to rescue them. Who is ready to gather an army to help? Very good. God used Saul to rescue his people. The people praised God and made Saul king. With God's help, Saul brought the Israelites together to win the battle, but he was not a perfect king. Who is our perfect king who always obeys God? That's right, it's Jesus. God sent his son Jesus to be our king forever. Jesus came to rescue people from sin and death. Our key passage is from the book of Isaiah, who was a prophet who saw God's throne. Isaiah knew how holy and amazing God was. God is our Lord and our King. Like Isaiah, the more we learn about God, the more we praise Him for His goodness, power, and holiness. Now, repeat the key passage after me. My eyes have seen the Lord. Isaiah chapter 6, verse 5. Let's sing the key passage song, Woe is Me, and our worship song.
I said, woe is me. 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 Woe is
It is so much fun singing the Key Passage song. I hope you sing it this week because it is a great way to help you remember our key passage. God used Saul to rescue his people from Nahash's army, but Saul could not rescue the people of Israel from sin. All people sin when they choose to disobey God. Our big picture question asks, why does sin separate us from God? The answer says, because God is holy. The good news is that God sent Jesus to rescue us from sin and be our King forever. For today's mission moment, look at the artist's idea of what David Brainhart may have looked like when he visited the Native Americans. David was one of the very first missionaries to the first people who lived in the United States. Imagine you're David in this picture. You might hear the sound of the Native American speaking to in their native language, seeing the Native Americans dressed in their native clothing, teepees, horses, smelling animals, campfires, feeling afraid or homesick, even tasting Native American food. When David decided to be a missionary to the Native Americans, he had to learn more than just the way they talk. He had to learn the way that they dress, eat, and live. Missionaries often have a lot to learn about the people that need to hear the good news about Jesus. Let's pray for missionaries all over the world as they tell the people about God's plan to send Jesus to rescue them from sin. Now let's close in prayer. Let us pray. Father, thank you for sending your son Jesus to be our King. Jesus, help us to listen to you and obey you. Help us to remember that we can always trust your plan. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. I hope you enjoyed today's lesson. Now work on your activity page with an adult. This week, I want you to pray that more Native Americans will trust in Jesus. Remember to subscribe to the Fort Bend Church YouTube channel, like and share this week's video. Have a wonderful week. See you all next time.
In the United States of America, during the 1700s, conflict between Native American people and European settlers was common. These two groups came from different cultures and held very different beliefs. But one man, David Brainerd, knew something both groups needed, the gospel. In 1742, David Brainerd became one of the first American missionaries to share the gospel with Native American people in their own language. At first, the work was slow. It was hard. David dealt with illness. He was mistreated by those who did not understand why he was sharing the gospel with Native American tribes. Still, David continued trusting God. He continued to learn the language of the tribe he was serving. David would wait 3 years before he would see the first Native American accept Jesus as his Savior. Soon, many more would follow. David Brainerd died a year later, but his legacy continues today. Missionaries are reaching more Native American people with the gospel, and many Native American believers are sharing the good news of Jesus with their tribes and beyond. I care not where or how I lived, or what hardships I went through, so I could but gain souls to Christ.